So the primary purpose of the budget was helping people now and fighting inflation in the process. But the longer sweep and context of the budget is important as well. Because we do need to build a new generation of prosperity for our people and our communities, and the budget was about that as well. You've heard it said and you've seen it written before that Australia has had three economies. The first was colonial and agricultural. The second was industrial behind a tariff wall. And the third was created when Paul and Bob opened us up to the global economy without selling out. And what we are now creating together is Australia's fourth economy by grasping the vast industrial and economic opportunities of the global net zero transformation, making ourselves an indispensable part of it, combining technology and human capital, heavy industries, new industries, and the care economy, leveraging our traditional strengths but powered by cleaner and cheaper energy. That's what a future made in Australia is all about. Modernising our economy and maximising our opportunities in a world of churn and change and on a path to net zero. Securing Australia's resilience and prosperity in a changing geostrategic and global economic environment. Now, anything this ambitious will invite a range of responses. I'm relaxed about that. Not all of those responses, in my view, are right. It attracts an exchange of views, and often that exchange of views is robust, and that's almost always a good thing. But what we're attempting here is not about repudiating anyone or anything from the past. We're building on it. The great reformers of the 1980s and 1990s weren't successful because they looked back and reached for the solutions that might have been right for the problems of 40 years prior. They were successful because they looked forward. They were successful because they recognised that the times had changed and the world was changing. They were successful because they were strategic rather than nostalgic, and because they recognised that our guiding light should always be to make our people the big beneficiaries of change. And that's what we're doing, by investing and engaging, not retreating or protecting, so that out of fragmented supply chains and new emerging markets, we can become an indispensable part of that new net zero economy and help power the future in the process. Now, the balance here is between targeted public investment and the much bigger pool of private investment that we hope to attract and unleash, not replace. Not a free-for-all of public spending crowding out private capital, but careful and considered incentives to crowd it in. That's what the Future Made in Australia Act is about as well, imposing the rigour and robustness and the framework so we can attract and enable private investment. So we can make Australia a renewable energy superpower, value adding to our resources and strengthening our economic security, backing Australian ideas and innovation in science and technology, and investing in people and place, in skills and education in our suburbs and regions. The Act will help us to make targeted, impactful public investments to get value for money. ARENA will help us commercialise the research and the innovation. Our financing facilities can help de-risk and reduce upfront capital costs for worthy projects. Production tax incentives for green hydrogen and processed critical minerals, which make tax breaks the biggest part of our package, will reward success and scale. And our reforms will improve the regulatory settings and approval processes, create new standards and new markets, and a new front door to make it easier for investors. Now, all of these initiatives will change the way we attract and deploy and improve the flow of capital in our economy and help create that new generation of prosperity for our people. So these are three of the main balances that we had to strike when we were forming up this budget, between global and domestic economic cross-currents, between cost of living relief now and maximising the opportunities of the future, and between public and private investment. But the balance on which all of these others depended in one way or another was the one that we struck with our fiscal strategy. Now, we have delivered a remarkable positive turnaround in the budget since we came to office. We've done it in a methodical and a considered way, because responsible economic management is a defining feature of this Albanese government and it's a defining feature of this budget as well. We were determined not to slash and burn while growth is slowing and people are hurting. We were determined to fight inflation without smashing the economy or dismantling essential services. Yes, we've had to grapple with fiscal pressures and unavoidable spending that impacts the bottom line, but that shouldn't diminish all of the progress that we have made over the last 2 years. The fact is, our balanced approach has been achieved alongside a stunning improvement in our nation's finances, including the fastest and biggest improvement of the budget position as a percentage of the economy on record.